Because if we say, excuse me, Professor, you didn't say I will. You said something different. Yeah, it's no good. We need to use them so that we understand them. Use them so that we understand. All right. We will prepare now for after the break. So we'll have a break in a moment. After the break, teacher Tom will ask 10 questions at random. Or different ones. Maybe he will ask different ones, but these will be some suggestions. Think about what your answers will be. What will you do next weekend? Is it a long weekend? Unfortunately not. It's a normal weekend. Yeah. What will you do next weekend? So think about what your answers will be. Of course you will use I'll, because you'll be talking about yourself. You will need one of these, because I don't think you're 100% sure. Yeah? Maybe you are. So you can use one of these, yeah? And then you need verbs. So think now, what will you do? What will you do for dinner tonight? Are you like me, that at 10 o'clock you already think about dinner? Are you the same as me? Okay.
For lunch.
Okay, good. Yes. Yes.
See you tomorrow. Tomorrow I enjoy the class.
Okay, yes.
People invite me for lunch.
Very nice.
Really far from me.
Oh, you deserve it.
Yeah.
I'll be here this week.
We have a morning talk.
That's right, tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
If you want. Yeah.
Yeah, tomorrow is okay.
Yeah. Any day is good, but tomorrow is good. This is good. Yeah, ask each other for help. Ask each other for help. With myself, in your music, subject area. I could not does it seem like giving cake?
No,
I think
cheaper.
I just don't know how you, I guess, broker, take this information and expand on it.
Okay.
The most useful thing to do is to try to put yourself in the shoes of the student. What would their questions be? So, maybe most likely, probably, I'd say that should follow the next page. Because she has the ability and she was made by her kids. Our most likely, probably, maybe I. Which I think is fair. I mean, those are the most common things that people express that idea. Thinking, putting myself in the shoes of a student, the obvious question is, well, here we have maybe at the beginning, here we have most likely in the middle. Am I free to put them where I choose? And the answer to that is yes. Say, I'll go shopping tomorrow, probably. So it can even be at the end.
Okay.
So, if you can look through the material, putting yourself in the shoes of a student, an inquisitive student, who's constantly saying, how come that's, you know, how come that's there? Well, yeah, more or less. The way that, I don't know when the last time was that you did a qualification on the product that needed a test for the code exercise. Did you?
It's been a while, now it's been several years.
Because I took health and safety qualifications, which is fairly technical sort of stuff, and some law and legislation and stuff like that. And some of it was technical stuff like minimum size of a room for a certain quantity of people, it's safe and so on. And what I learned from doing that, everything that was in the book was necessary. So if it was in there, it was because I needed to know it. And it's the same approach with a book like this.
So testing a qualification. It's been a while since I've had an English qualification, but I've had a qualification.
Yeah, like updating skills on various different things. And generally, the material that they give you for the book or booklets, if it's in there, it means that you need it.
Okay.
That's the general principles. Whereas in the past, if you look back at the history of education, the history of instruction, you had lacking books that were this big. And the secret was the opposite. The secret was to pull the book apart and only study what you really needed.
Okay.
You didn't need it all. And this was like a guiding principle. The guiding principle today is that if it's in there, it's because it's necessary. You don't have to do it like this. I mean, another way to do it is to, obviously, which is what we're basically doing, anyway, go through the books, but allow lots of time for questions and discussion that might come out of, the book.
Well, yours is a very clear approach to what's in here, with more detail.
It's also simple in terms of content that know all of this.
Okay.
But this pronunciation of all, this I'll, you'll, it's worth practicing. So although the content is not new to these students, not by a long way, the pronunciation is worth practicing. Some students might not have seen most likely before, or they have seen it somewhere a long time ago. They know maybe they're not problematic. Most likely, is less common. So it's good to include it in there and say, well, basically it's part of that. Probably most likely maybe group of words. So you don't have to have amazingly profound things ready. If you, in terms of preparation, if you can look at the material and think of other examples, there's only a couple of examples here that let me elaborate on that then. As well, we look at it. You don't need to have anything profound or grammatical. Examples are great, the more the better. Also, turn statements into questions. that's another big thing. Whenever you have a statement, try to get in there what the question is. Because we've been doing algo fishing, algo shopping. But of course we also need to know, does the question follow the same rules of this whole other answer that it does? What will you do if you win the lottery? What will he do for dinner? What will he cook for dinner? So we do have it all, but it attaches itself to the question. Where will you live when you're at college? So another thing to bear in mind is whenever you have a statement, try to make it to the question. See if that's a good way.
Talk, basically these are instructions for students.
same.
What we do as teachers, we draw their attention to the instructions, read them alongside them, answer any doubts that these instructions are for them. We read these, they read. Again, this is a contrast with the old-fashioned concept of teaching, which is today's a reading lesson, which means the teacher reads to us. Today's a writing lesson, which means that the teacher writes something on the board and the teacher says how to write it. It's not the concept that we have today. Write means they write, the read means they read. We are the guardians.
I may be go to hunting.
Countryside. Would it be okay to say that I probably go to the country?
Yes.
Is it the same as the countryside?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Countryside.
Same in British English. It's the same.
Yeah, you don't have to say
countryside. Right. Yeah, same with us. Yeah, it's good. Probably go to the country.
Is Dan?
Yeah.
Okay. What'll you do if you miss the bus?
I am go to high school.
Miss the bus.
Sorry.
I'll go fishing.
I am a dog.
It is even say flag the taxi.
I'll probably flag a taxi down
here.
You can
call.
Or flag a taxi down
here. When you were old, you went to the middle.
What will you do on your birthday?
More likely, I go make merit.
Are you familiar with the phrase to make merit?
I'm not.
Great. Explain to teacher Tom, all of you, what does it mean to make merit?
On your birthday. You go to the temple.
Okay.
And some food or something for your mom.
Okay.
To make a merit.
Okay, I understand.
Yeah.
Okay.
When do you make merit? Any particular, are there special days?
Special days.
Which days?
Buddha days.
Yeah,
Buddha days. Special days.
Yeah. Any other days?
Yeah.
Which mm-hmm. days? I don't know. I'm not an expert. Is it common to make merit on your birthday?
Yes.
Yeah. Is that?
I think it's normal, maybe an impression, but I'm very with Buddhist family.
Okay.
When my husband's birthday, I prepare food, and I tell my mate, you want to go to temple with married for my husband and go to church.
Okay.
But I prepare food.
Yeah.
Okay. For money.
Yes. So you are a mixed family. There are Christians and Buddhists in your family.
My three children are Christians.
Christians.
My two daughters, she married a Catholic.
Yes, from Japan.
Japan and Florida.
And Florida, yeah.
But my two daughters, they changed from Christian to the Catholic. Yeah. Only one son, same.
3 months. So,
yeah. Right.
What will you do for dinner tonight?
Most likely, I will cook special food.
Okay.
For me.
Do you cook every day?
Yes, I love to cook.
Okay. I see everybody eating out every night. They're at the street food. And I thought, nobody cooks. I thought, everybody must go out to eat at night.
Eat out is not good for the health.
No.
Many people don't have a kitchen.
Yeah.
Especially in Bangkok, is that true?
Yes, yes.
Many people don't have a kitchen. Mm-hmm. Typically, a typical working person's apartment will have a kitchen.
Okay.
And they're probably not allowed to have gas stoves or anything like that.
Oh, yeah.
So I think it's quite common that people don't cook. Would you agree?
I think it's 50 or 60% people.
Okay,
cool.
But in a city of 30 million people, that's a lot of people who don't cook.
But it's in Bangkok.
In Bangkok, yeah, we're talking about Bangkok.
I don't cook. Mm. I don't cook. Mm. Because I stay alone.
Yes.
Mm. You buy outside, it's very
expensive. Yes.
You use it by yourself, it's expensive.
More expensive.
Yes. Mm. And you buy some, but it's worth 40 baht.
Yes.
So cheap.
I eat out every night.
Yeah.
Yes.
You say know how to
clean it's
how
easy.
To clean
it's fast.
Easy. Yes. Yes. What is the oily to cook food?
Yeah.
She is a big family. Okay. No, it's not big. Just
no.
3 months. Just 3 months.
Like the.
I love to cook.
Yeah. Yes.
The real
part. Daughter-in-law, son-in-law, what? Many, many one time.
The real mom part, the actual, the dimensions of the of what they call an apartment, like your study.
Okay.
That's how most single working people, young couples, live.
Okay. Yeah.
So no kitchen, and you can't just set up a gas cooker on the balcony.
No.
And
no.
Have it.
Well, I also see. People buying fresh vegetables. And if I see that, I think they're going home to cook.
Mm-hmm.
Because I would not buy the fresh vegetable because I can't cook. But I do see people buying the vegetables. So maybe they cook.
Yeah. Well, some,
I guess maybe.
Yeah. I have friends who maybe they prepare salad things at home. They might prepare some cold dishes at home.
Okay.
But they never cook.
So one more. Okay. What will you do if your phone stops working?
I will most likely buy a new one.
Start with you, okay?
Yes,
okay. What'll you do on your birthday?
Mm-hmm.